So it's little Archie's turn. It's a little Archie. Yes. So here is lovely Archie. And I'm going to do him on a 2-comb, 6mm, purple, number 2, as I call it, purple number 2. So it kind of looks like 5F for those who want to be technical. It's just like a 5F length. Not as short as a 7, to give him a little bit of velvety look. But if it's not quite, this kind of hair is quite difficult to cut, so if it's not catching that way, you take a longer comb, like the 4 or a 3 even, and reverse it up. It'll just catch it a little bit better and give that nice and plush effect. Then you can go over with your scissors and your blenders after for any other little bits that might not be, you know, caught with the clippers. Just to make the whole thing look lovely and neat and tidy. And you could do your comb over scissors as well, even if you wanted to make it quite nice and neat. So lift with your comb, look for your ends, and tidy up that way. It depends how well your dog stands for you, really. Now just give that nice, neater effect. So there's all sorts of techniques you could use on this. Some people might just say, oh, just shave it off. But, you know, there is a nice and neater way to do it. And overall, it looks a lot better. And gives a nicer effect. And I find it enjoyable to do. You know. People say, oh, you're lazy if you use, you know, combs and things, but if you can use your combs and you go over with your scissors, you get a lot of practice with your scissors and your blenders and all your other tools. So it's not being lazy, it's just using your equipment well. In your commercial environment, which is what we are. We only have a limited time in which to make our dogs look lovely. Obviously, the more time that we take, the more, you know, if we were going to scissor it all, we're going to take a little bit more time, so it's going to cost people more. But I could probably do the same sort of things just by quickening it up by using my combs. And then going over with the scissors to give it a neater look. Because some people do just use the combs and they never go over with the scissors and blenders. They never give it that neat finish. But it does make all the difference. People will notice your trimming a little bit more. Even those that are not even bothered, or, you know, I'll get a message about saying, oh, you look really nice today, what did you do? I just went over a bit more with scissors today, you know. It makes us feel like we're using our skills, adapting our skills I'm not terribly good at learning book stuff, but it is good to know all these things. It's nice to have them nice and neat because it'll grow better. It'll grow in tandem. Might be short, but it's neat and it's beautiful. Comb it out, look at your odds and ends. Neat! You're a little tinker, you are.
Yeah, so Archie's had two on his...
Oh, squeaky wheel down there.
He's had his two and his bits of blending and trimming and all that, haven't you?
So, because his body's really short, I'm going to do a really short head as well. So I'm just going to go over with the two. Over the top of his head. He has sort of a swept back look. Not really, really short, but just swept back out of his eyes. Good boy. There you go, there's short on the side of his face on the two as well. Side as well, underneath chin, pull this up. I know your mummy will be here, I promise you, not long now. Bulkiness off his head there with the two, and the rest we can blend, so we could get our little blenders and just take that off in with your eyes there. Oh dear me. Is it the end of the world as you know it? It's the end of the world, isn't it? Yes. Blend any bits back there. Show any bits that's sticking out here. Luna likes to be the centre of attention, don't you? She does. Okay, do the other side. Generally do the same with all my dogs, so we'll lift up the top there and I'll trim the bottom. any gooey stuff that's in here, trim that off. And then I comb it down. And anything that's hanging over, I don't know if you can quite see that. Trim that off. Same on this side, lift that up. Trim that off, sure, there. And then comb down. Trim that. And then we generally go forward. Hand in front of it, haven't I? And you might notice that I hold my comb in my hand a lot of the time. I just find it time saving. Instead of putting it down on the table, I'll just put it in my hand. Or sometimes I put it under my arm. Oh, not quite ready. 5 minutes. Just need to do the end of his ears. Mum's come. It's okay when people turn up early now because I can just stick my head out the window and say, can you just give me 5? So I'll just check where his ears is. A bit shorter than that one, I think. There we go.
lovely Larchie. So I've got Lassie and Lola, my last two customers of the day. This is Lola, and is it Lola? Lola is there. Lottie, the other one, but I'll show you in a second. I've done her from a puppy. Lola came after as a rehome. They do keep in touch with the people that they had Lola from. Unfortunately, if you remember when I had COVID, if you watched all the other videos further on, a few of my customers had to go to other dog groomers for one-offs, so because I just couldn't get them back in. When I'm so forward booked, it's hard to then do extra dog, so because I was off for 10 days, diary just got in a mess. Most people waited, and a few, obviously, that didn't have appointments actually as a list in my diary, I had to go and see other groomers, which was absolutely fine. They were fine. She's quite chilled out today, aren't you, Lola? So we should just have a little bit of separation anxiety. But she's very good to groom. She's a very good girl. We just have a three. And I'm going to shorten up her ears because they're a bit too long. They're in like this there. So I'm going to give her ears a really good trim. We all groom different as, you know, groomers. So I'm just going to put my normal style that I put in back in. So I'll crack on. But they both have threes. Nice short faces, trimmed up tails, and they're good to go for about 8 weeks. And this one's Lottie. She is so lovely. I'll have to see if I can find a picture of her when she was a baby. She was so cute. She's got like this different, like grey silver colour. And her out, yeah. Yeah, so she's just gonna have the same and give her, shape up your face and give you a nice short three, tiny little tail. Yeah. And that's it. So going to get them both in the bath. I think if I've got time towards the end, I'll try and show you a bit of the face shape that I put in once I've blown all the hair out and I've done their bodies. So Lola is all bathed and ready. She has got an awful lot of hair on her head. One of the things I make sure that I do is good preparation. When you get good preparation, you spend time on your bathing and blow drying, you get the coat nice and straight. When you go over it, it gives you a nice even finish. She has got a lot of hair on her head. Now when I'm thinking about my long-term trims, I make sure that certain areas, like the whole dog is balanced, but things like undergroin areas, short, inside feet, nice short. When I'm doing my head and things like that, I might take the inside of the ear out. I won't leave too much hair on the side of the head here, because the ear is going to go on top and it helps it, the air flow through. So I try and balance out the whole groom really, and I think about how, you know, many weeks are going in between their trims. So Lottie and Lola come every 8 week ish so they have a three trim, which I do a 3F blade on my commercial flipper. commercial clipper, I use a 3, all over their body and down their legs, and then I do the head and their feet. And what I tend to do when I'm going back over after I've used my clipper, I might use my 3 comb on my Arco or my brow. So I use my 3 and I'll go over and catch any little bits, and then I'll comb it up and I'll scissor it to make it all nice and neat. Because the neater it is, the better it will keep. And then when I come to do it again, I'll blow it all out again and I'll do the scissor it down and I'll do the same thing all over again. Obviously, the head's a bit overgrown, so we really need to balance that in with the body. Because, you know, when I'm thinking about, I hope this is making sense, when I'm thinking about when they're at home and things like that, and how it is easier for the owners to look after. If they haven't got big, long, heavy ears, and there's lots of hair inside there and here, all the areas that get knotted up, I make sure I take sort of armpit hair out, groin area, feet, I keep them in a manageable length. Then I know in about 8 weeks' time, they're generally, I can just put them in the bath, groom them all out, put that same trim over. I tend to find if they're not getting too knotty, then I can sort of, they don't get the behavioural issues, because it is quite uncomfortable to have knots and things groomed out. So what I'll do is I'll take her body off and her legs off, I'll come back to her head, and I'll show you how I do a nice chunky foot, because she's having a 3, it's the same length all over, but I like to do a nice chunky foot. It's just, I just find more appealing, and I just think visually it looks a lot nicer, it looks more sort of teddy bear-ish, so I'll do that. So because it took me quite a long time to bath and blow dry them today. But I would rather spend more time on that, because then it makes the trim a lot quicker, because my blades and my combs and everything's going to glide through and the trimming's done in quick time. So so we'll come back when I've got the majority of the body and the legs up. Right, so I'm hoping that you're going to be able to see this okay. Obviously, if I had a head cam, I would be able to give you a better angle, but we've got what we've got. So basically, she's had a 3. Can you move your head? No way. There we are. She's had a 3 all over on the 3F. On the 3F. And then I've gone over with my 3 combs, get bits off, lift it up, and then I've scissored over. And then another trick, when you've actually finished, if you just go with a little bit of finishing spray, very lightly, I'll just comb it in, it all sits in lovely and neat. And then any other little ends that you can see, you can just tidy up, make sure that they're neat. Because I always like to finish with scissors, because you know when you've had a really good trim on your hair, it feels in good condition. It feels in really good condition, and it gives a better finish and a better feel, and the coat stays in better condition. Rather than just going over with the clippers, then to actually just, to go over and finish little ends, to make it nice. Anyway, we're doing a foot now. So my foot I'm going to use my little Spectra because I like this clipper on feet. I don't feel like it's going to graze them because it's a ceramic blade there. So I'll just hit it on the number two stem. And what I do is I'll take the inside of the hair. I wonder if I should go on the other side. You might see it a bit better. Hang on a second. So while I'm doing the inside of the foot, I'll stand this side. So there is the foot. Just pulling up the area. Now, the reason why I take it nice and short is because obviously she's coming every 8 weeks. So she's going out on walks and stuff like that. And they're going mud and grass and all sorts of stuff. And it gets stuck to the hair inside the foot and it can set. It's not wiped off or, you know, it gathers in there and, you know, friction walking. It can just build up like mats inside. And it's almost like a hard horseshoe sometimes. So it needs to be taken out on the inside of the foot there. Just gently remove all the hair. These mini trimmers are ideal. I mean, they are expensive. The you know, the Brava and the Arco aren't as expensive, but they have got a metal blade. Used on the very short setting, you know, you could possibly graze, so I'd always recommend the longer setting on them. But I do like these for inside feet. I did have some others for a really cheap pair. Let me see if I can find them. These ones here. These are just a really cheap pair, but the battery's gone dead. I haven't had a chance to charge it up, but that has different settings on as well. And because it's a nice ceramic blade, you feel a bit safer using it on feet. So, and they're sort of relatively cheap. You can get them on Amazon. So it's really important to keep these feet clear, because I won't see you for another 8 weeks. And I generally find if I keep them nice and short, it's going to last and I don't get the mats inside the feet. So you see now, the nice little teddy bear foot. Next thing I do is the nails. Tip off the nails. And I do that first so that I can get a nice shape on the foot. Oh, a nail there. Right, so. And then, what I'll do. Comb that all out. Now you can either do the front, back, the back, front, whichever you like. This is my method anyway. So what I'll do is I'll just cut across the back, straight across like that. Like that. And then I'm going to swap to the other side. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to comb forward. I'm hoping you can see this. Let me see if I can go to this side. Will that make it any better? Is that better? And I just trim right above the toenail like that. I'm actually not bothered if I see a nail, but it's cuter if it's not seen. So I'll just go straight across the toe like that. And the reason why I do the back front or front back first is that I find that if I was to cut the sides like that, I end up with a pointy foot. So if I just cut it straight at the back, cut it straight at the front, and then comb that out, and then I'm I'm gonna round it up at the sides. Inside here to see if there's any little mats inside each turn, like that. A little snip. Like that. Lift it up. You see? And then I tend to go over like a dome. Put down. Bring that up. And then what I'll do is I'll lift the whole thing up. Definitely need to invest in some camera situations. And then I'm going to neaten up this, both sides, all this that's sticking out. You like to put your head in the way, don't you? Can you see it coming now? You can see with this foot as well. And what I also like to do is get my little brush and I'll brush it down. And all these little bits here snip off. So you rest your head on my arm. Your feet today. I think it's the heat, isn't it? It has gone warm all of a sudden. I don't know if I might have been covering that. Was I then covering that? I'm not sure. This is getting on my nerves here. This keeps jingling. We'll move those out of the way, I think. So yeah, can you see how they look? But you know, nice and chunky. Round. Definitely need to sort some camera situation out, don't we? Right, so I'm going to switch over there and I'll go through the head. I also need to do her tail.